and welcome back to the channel, everybody.
And if you're new here, hello and welcome.
This is Motor Mike Media,
and as always, I'm Motor Mike, and today, well, we're going to talk about the 2022 Bentley Continental GT Speed.
And the Speed is the highest performance model for the Continental GT. It looks real sharp. We'll start with styling in the front end. The front end has this big, bold presence to it. The big, large, and in charge Bentley grille up front, but for the Speed, it's all blacked out. And the nice headlights. They have a nice, elegant, and classy look to them. When Bentley first started doing the four lights overall, I wasn't the biggest fan, but it looks really sharp on this latest Continental GT. Now, the side profile, and here's where I really love this vehicle. I love a silhouette of a coupe, and this one looks great. The long hood going up over the cab of the vehicle. Simple yet strong body lines. What I really like is how the rear hips of the vehicle actually has that nice curve that goes around the wheel well. It looks real sharp in my opinion. And the rear end, once again, looks very classy. Nice taillights in the rear ends. The latest styling that Continental or Bentley is doing with them. It has a nice look to it. I like the dual exhaust down below. This vehicle, yes, it's very expensive, so it has that nice luxurious feel to it, but it's very brawny at the same time. Almost has a muscle car feel, or look to it, I should say. So let's talk about that interior. That interior, guys, is just amazing. On the regular Continental GT, you can get real woods, metals, and all this stuff, but for the Speed, they made it a little bit more performance-oriented. So these seats, they're leather, Alcantara, premium stitching. They hold you in place, but are still very comfortable. Even the back seats, I like how they have the quilted pattern / the sport bucket seats to hold you in place. It's a cool look. The dash is premium materials, leather, carbon fiber, real metals. Most of the switchgear is metal or very high premium material. Nice steering wheel in front of the driver, a digital gauge cluster, and a big helper screen with all your information. It's the latest system from Bentley. It's a great system to use. And the cool thing is, you can just hit a button and the whole screen will flip. You can go to a nice simple 3 analog gauges or even to just a blank panel. So depending on what you want to do, you can kind of go more old school or stay with the modern times. This interior is just, like I said, very premium, very upscale. Nice high quality buttons, like I said, around the gear selector, and it is a regular gear selector. Now the gear selector is actually an 8-speed dual clutch transmission, so you just have lightning quick shifts. Now let's talk about the power plant. Like I said, you have the 8-speed dual clutch. What is it attached to? Well, it's attached to a 6-liter W12, that's right, a W12 engine that makes 650 horsepower and 664 pound-feet of torque. This thing is a monster, but it is a very big, heavy, luxurious vehicle with lots of goodies. So it basically does a 0-60 in 3.5 seconds. That's very good numbers for such a large and charged vehicle with all the premium luxuries. A top speed of 208 miles per hour, and this is, like I said, a very expensive vehicle. It's going to be around $260,000 around there when it comes out. And obviously, Bentley, they always have options. You can add things, special colors and unique patterns to make it a little bit unique and different. But I really like this, guys. I can never afford one, but I've always liked the Continental GT, and this newest version of it is more upscale, more premium, while still having that brawniness to it. And the Speed version, just those little tweaks they make to the exterior and the interior, they're like the icing on the cake. But I wonder what you guys think. What are things you like about it? What are things you don't like about it? I personally don't like the price, but that's what you get with a luxury car like this. But if you guys haven't already and you want to, check out my channel. I keep trying to give you guys more and more content. It's about cars, trucks, crossovers, and SUVs, combustion engines, just like this W12, and EVs, a little of everything. But please, like, comment, subscribe. Hit the notification bell. That way you guys can stay up to date with the latest and greatest for my channel. I got a Patreon now. A couple different tiers for you guys. Early access to some of my videos. It really helps me and the channel grow. But as always, I truly, truly appreciate you guys for watching. And I'll see y'all in the next one.